time is now for live video highlights of your school's March to Excellence.
Noon sets up inside of the pitch. High fly to left. It's up, it's deep, and it's going to be gone!
Legacy Sports Network brings you high-quality HD video broadcasted by the best in the business.
Handoff, Adam Taylor lunges to the end zone, touchdown!
This is one of the most exciting things.
With all the runs, hits, scores, and more, we're building a legacy one game at a time.
I appreciate it, Gerald. You guys at Legacy do an unbelievable job.
Join us on pay-per-view or video live streaming your favorite high school and college athletics at LegacySportsNetwork.com.
Legacy Sports Network is going to be bringing this presentation to your home.
Kingwood High School is coming off one of the most successful seasons in recent memory. In fact, when the Kingwood softball team avenged an earlier season loss to Deer Park in the Class 5A state semifinals, the Mustangs were guaranteed to play in a 2013 state team final in the following sports, including boys and girls rugby, track, boys golf, girls lacrosse, boys soccer, gymnastics, and swimming.
Yeah, if you're not counting our sports that aren't UIL sanctioned, like rugby and lacrosse, 11 of our teams have been. So it's a great day to be a Mustang, and I'm really proud of being from Kingwood, and I'm proud to represent Kingwood softball, and I think our community, our fans, and our team is awesome. I wouldn't trade them for anything.
Kingwood head coach Lauren Hendricks played shortstop for the Mustangs 14 years ago. In fact, this was the first time since 1993 that Kingwood reached the state tournament in softball. Starting pitcher Cassie McClure helped guide the Mustangs to the finals with four runs batted in, thanks in part to a two-run homer in the state semifinals. She earned the victory in the circle as well, as the Mustangs outran the Deer of Deer Park 9-3.
I just wanted to pitch my heart out these last two games because my last two games with my high school.
She's amazing. We couldn't have asked anything else of Cassie. And she pitched her heart out and hit the ball very well, and she's played well all season, and she came here and showed everybody what she's made of.
The 9-run outburst against the Deer was nothing new, but the Mustangs were held in check in the state finals as Mary Beth Gorsuch of Louisville held Kingwood scoreless for the first six innings, striking out eight while walking just one batter.
They're a very good hitting team, and I knew that, and I knew I had to keep them off balance, and by doing that, I had to throw every pitch possible, and by doing that, I knew they were going to hit the ball, and my team had my back.
I think she did very well, and she made us look silly. She struck us out more than we ever struck out this season, so I think she did very well.
McClure gave up three runs in the state title game against Louisville. A two-run single by Becca Scott was hard enough to swallow, but a solo homer by Miranda Worthington was a mistake pitch, according to McClure.
Yeah, it was a rise ball, so I probably should have known that she shouldn't throw because her hands were up high, so she'll hit everything that's high, but she can't even touch anything that's low. I should have known that, but we all have mistakes.
This single to start the sixth by Kingwood's Anna Oliacek was erased by a double play. Louisville's 3-0 lead seemed insurmountable, but Ariana Zernial gave the Stangs hope with a two-run triple with two outs to cut the Fighting Farmers' lead to one.
You know, my hat's off to these kids, man. We knew, you know, that they weren't going to lay down and die on us, and we knew we were going to have to get that third out.
Oliacek was at the plate again with another RBI opportunity as Zernial stood at third base as the tying run. Down to her final strike and final out, Anna was called over to her head coach, who was coaching third base. Hendricks put the suicide squeeze play on, but Oliacek pulled the bat back on a high pitch. Unfortunately for Kingwood, Zernial was hung out to dry halfway down the third base line. She got caught in a rundown and was tagged out for the game's final play. A heartbreaking way to end an incredible season for Kingwood.
Yeah, she's got to trust in it and go with it. All she had to do is go for it. She didn't go for it. So I don't think it was her. It could have happened. We could have scored that run in seven other innings.
I never knew they would do that. I mean, that girl was really fast. When she started running, I was like, why is she off the base? Because we ran this play over and over and over again in practice, and I knew we would get her out.
We worked a lot last week on rundowns and what would happen. And fortunately, it just came out on our end of the stick.
The Mustangs' two runs were their lowest offensive output in 14 games, and their 22-game winning streak was snapped.
It was exciting, and then we had nerves this game. I had nerves. I know I did.
I think it was a bit nerves, too. And again, just they had several key defensive plays. I mean, they came out to play, and they did very well.
It was a great season. I love everyone on the team. I'm going to miss them.